So here we are in the sweet shop in Westwood Ho. It's called So Sweet. And Nastya and Tanya and Eniku and Leia are now going to write down 10 names of sweets that they find interesting for whatever reason.
Are these sweets made in England? Are they all British brands?
Yes.
Or no?
Yeah, most of the sweets you find in the shop are a British brand. Barring all our American section that we get, the American info, they are strictly from America itself. So, yes, most of our sweets are English made.
Your own sweets?
Like, no, I'm afraid we don't.
And what about the names of chocolate, for example, or some sweets, for example, Psychomice? Or do you create the names yourself?
No, we don't actually. A lot of the sweets that you find in the shop is like really the old fashioned sweets that you used to get years and years ago. So if you're around about in, say, around about 80, you'll find the really old sweets that you used to have when you were a little child. So it's very much of a difference. Some of there's new sweets and there's really old-fashioned sweets that you will find in the shop. Okay?
Do you tell us what's just...
Actually, I do.
Is it difficult for you to work here?
It is sometimes, but I do keep it under control.
So what are the names of those?
Sweet Tarts, you've got Nerds, Laffy Taffy, and the Gobstoppers. They're all American, which you will find on their own over that section with American important stuff is. But this is a massive baggie with 150 pieces inside.
And why do they call them Gobstoppers?
Obviously,
no. And rock?
rock
that you've got. What's rock?
A rock is like a peppermint. It's like a peppermint stick.
Uh-huh.
Covered in really, really sugary sweet. Uh-huh. With a mint flavour. And on the inside, if I show you, on this one. Unwrap that to show you. It's broken. See? Come get it.
Words.
It should say Westwood Ho. But I don't. Yeah, Westwood Ho. You got it there?
Yeah.
On each rock, yeah?
Let me guess. This must be a very popular souvenir.
It is. It is brand new as well, and it's very, very popular.
Yeah.
I'm a fan of products.
Yeah. The price went up.
So, here we have our teachers exploring the sweet shop. There's so much in this sweet shop to learn from linguistically. Fizzy, sour, rainbow twists, a licorice explosion, psycho, mice, baby dolphins, giant suckers, strawberry tarts, juicy lips. Yeah? And it'd be interesting, we'll have a look and we'll see which 10 sweets our teachers chose to write down. Mini love hearts. Oh, this is my childhood. Pink and white mallows. Yeah? Assorted twist mallows. And of course fudge. Fudge crunch. Rum and raisin fudge. Clotted cream fudge. And fish and chips. That's a funny kind of fish and chips. Lots of fruits here. Apple bonbons, lemon bonbons, blue raspberry cubes, strawberry bonbons, and over here we've got
black currant licorice.
So, Nastia, you recognize this?
Yes.
So what is it?
This is a wonderful painted wall. This wall was painted by Mel, and here's her signature, like her website. She's a wonderful girl, and she also a very talented girl. And she told us that while working here, that was very difficult to do it really bright, because we are in the sweet shop, and all the colors should be bright and sweet. And she had lots of difficulties in choosing the colors. And I suppose she spent more than 5 hours just doing this. But like so little corner and so much colors.
What can you see? And what has she painted?
A bottle of soda or sweet water, ice cream, lollipops, then some sweets.
What's this here?
This?
Yes.
Dolphin, little dolphin. Here I found sweets, and the name was baby dolphins.
Can you find them? Can you show me?
Yeah. Yes.
Baby dolphins. Yeah, so not only baby dolphins, but also...
Yeah, giant dolphins.
Giant dolphins. Yeah. Great. So, Annika, which sweets are you choosing?
Yeah, I'm thinking about which one to choose for my family and friends.
Good, yes.
For example, I have chosen pineapple.
And what are they called? Pineapple?
Cubes.
Yeah. And what's a cube? Do you know what a cube is?
This form, not
the form,
this form.
The shape,
yes.
Like dice, when you shake dice, cube, same.
Yeah.
And what else are you going to choose?
And I'm going to choose chocolate as well, because chocolate is very popular in our family and I like it. So, there is a very, very wide choice.
Right.
Choice.
Chocolate drops here.
Yes,
I remember liking those when I was a child. Okay. Chocolate drops.
Ah.
Yeah. They're very nice. So, what was that experience like?
I was good. Lady was really nice. Yeah, she was a wonderful person. Yeah, I wish her all the joy in her job that she can have.
So, what did you think of the sweet shop, Nastia?
I think that people with different tastes they can find something for their own tooth. Sweet tooth.
Yes.
And
something to their own liking.
Yeah.
To their own liking.
To their own liking.
Mm.
And also, we can find jelly, we can find ice cream, not only chocolate or not only lollipops.
Mm.
So, different tastes and different kinds of sweets.
Mm-hmm. Good.
So
here we are, Westwood Ho. There's a Hawkins ice cream van over there, and the tide is out, quite a long way out. I think it's high tide today at about 6 o'clock, and it's about 10:45 now, so it's more or less at the lowest, yeah? And what a great sweet shop. I didn't know whether you recognise the name here.
Yes, Rudyard Kipling.
Uh-huh.
Ah.
And Annika, what do you know about Rudyard Kipling?
He was an English writer, British writer.
Mm-hmm.
He wrote, for example, Kim. And I used to study about him, but I unfortunately have forgotten.
Right.
Maybe he used to live in India. In India as well.
Yes.
Yes, and he used to write Jungle Book, of course,
Yes. And Tanya, why is this here? This is called a plaque, where you have writing on a stone, on a wall. Why is it here?
Because Rudyard Kipling was educated here. January 1878 to July 1882, right. And under
Kummel Prize. Good, yeah. So, where exactly? Where? If we look up?
Okay, this is a
The name of a road?
Nelson.
Which is?
Nelson.
And who was Nelson? Who was Nelson?
Nelson, Admiral.
Yes.
And the statue in London.
The statue in London, yeah. Yeah, what do you know, Tanya, about Nelson?
Nelson was a hero in Britain.
Yes, he was a British hero, yeah?
Yeah.
And what battle is associated with Lord Nelson? Where?
Trafalgar.
The Battle of Trafalgar, which was in 1805. Now, do you remember when we first went to Appledore, I showed you a street sign with two names. Do you remember the names?
Oh, no. Scott Trafalgar.
Scott and Trafalgar.
Yeah.
So again, we have a similar maritime feel to it.